Boeing CEO David Calhoun is hinting that the aerospace manufacturer is still considering a 787 Dreamliner freighter variant as a next-generation replacement for the 767 freighter. The company is actually working on a timeline, since production of its 767 and 777 freighters must stop by 2027 to comply with emission regulations. Let's examine the situation and resulting possibilities in today's video. With Boeing's 767 freighter program coming to a close within the next 5 years, speculation is high on what will replace the wide-body cargo workhorse. While the Boeing 777F has found its replacement in the form of the Boeing 777-8F, Boeing CEO David Calhoun recently revealed that a 787 freighter is high up in the list of 767F successors. According to FreightWaves, Calhoun said the following: "We know there's value in a 787 freighter, but we're going to pace all of our freighter developments. We have a 777 coming down the pike. The legacy 767 is still in wild demand. Someday, probably likely, but we've not pulled any triggers." At the same time, it's being reported that Boeing will also consider developing a completely new airframe for a freighter with a passenger variant following after. However, the company is still receiving plenty of orders for existing freighters and passenger-to-freighter or P2F conversions. Developing a Boeing 787F will prove challenging in a number of ways, particularly as the Dreamliner's carbon fiber structure will make it more difficult to reinforce the significantly larger cargo doors. The company only just restarted Boeing 787 Dreamliner deliveries last month following a 14-month hiatus due to production issues, and is also grappling with huge debts of around $45 billion. While Boeing has developed freighter variants from its other wide-body programs with the 747, 767, and 777, it hasn't done so for the 787, which has otherwise sold well with orders for around 1,500 units. In the past, Simple Flying explored on its website why the world hasn't seen a 787 freighter, concluding that the expensive development costs and the existence of viable alternatives were key factors. But with regulatory pressures bearing down on the company, the end result might just be a Dreamliner freighter. Speaking on the topic of air cargo demand, Calhoun was quoted as saying, "I don't think there will be a give back to some other form of transportation. I think they're going to keep what they have. I don't think it can accelerate at the same pace it did, but even if it returned to its pre-COVID pace, it's going to be a very healthy, very robust market." Despite Calhoun's assertion, some analysts are concerned that the air cargo market will be oversupplied with freighters after the COVID pandemic bubble bursts and supply chain issues are resolved. So what about you? Do you think Boeing will develop a 787 freighter? Or do you see the company opting for something else? Let us know your insights in the comments. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.